D&D Dungeon Masters of Reddit. What is the most useless magical item you've ever given your party and how did they use it? Not the DM, but the guy who used the item. I got a corncob pipe that made bubbles. Seriously, that's it. Just bubbles. They didn't put people to sleep. They didn't explode under flames. Nothing. Maybe it would make someone's eyes burn if they rubbed it in. We were assaulting a town and I was part of the crew taking the gatehouse. We barred the windows and doors and I put the pipe under the edge of the door and blew like I was inflating my own life raft in the ocean. Soon, bubbles were pouring out at the seams and the guards inside were panicking hardcore. One of them tripped on something and hurt himself on his own weapon. Once we opened the door, they came stumbling out and we cut them down while they were disoriented and distracted. Shortly thereafter, I traded the stupid pipe for various types of arrows at a Fletcher. I had that dang pipe for a long time and only used it that once. I would have pulled that thing out every time I made an investigation check. So a friend told me a story of his one time that fits the bill, I think. At some point in a homebrew game, the party gets their hands on a wand of magic farts. Point and fart. Literally, they used it to sneak around quite effectively for a while. Then they had to deal with a cult with a secret mountain hideout. Traveled through a cave system until they reached the antechamber with four lit braziers around the altar. My friend, a wizard, uses the wand until he rolls a 1. The wand then springs a leak, spraying methane and slowly filling the chamber. Everyone bolts out as the wizard runs around the room before chucking the wand at the altar and following suit. They get out just in time to seal the entrance and blow off the top of the mountain. Literally, they were blinded and deafened for 3 turns each. We were playing a campaign with custom items we all put in, they were reasonable, and someone put in a stuff that whenever someone used it, it turned the user into a potato. They could still move and turn themselves back but that was about it. So we were in a dungeon that was rather small. Our 6-foot barbarian was angry that he had a debuff, but there was a small slit in the wall that I hid an item behind and our magic man went poof and rolled into the slit and got a key for a chest at the end of the dungeon. So yeah, why is Potato Rick the joke you guys came up with? Because it's the exact same joke that my friend made when we put the item in the game. He turned himself into a potato. Funniest crap I've ever seen. I wasn't the DM, but the DM of one of my favorite campaigns I've ever played gave me an item called the Book of Misspells. As you would expect, it was a book of various level spells that I could use without any restrictions other than I could only use them once a day. However, every spell was not what was actually written in the book. For example, the extremely powerful wish spell actually turned out to be wash. I first found the book calling out to my sorcerer character from deep in a forest, and one of my companions followed me in to make sure I stayed safe. When I found the book, it exuded magical energy, but the cover had no name written on it. I tried the message spell on my companion next to me to be safe. He stared at me uncomfortably as he was given a massage instead. Not the DM, but the player. Early in a Pathfinder campaign, we came across a robe of bones. Our GM loves to monkey paw items, so when he told us this robe had skeletons printed on it, and if we peeled them off, we'd summon skeleton warriors, we were skeptical they'd definitely fight on our side. Anyway, we were level 3 at the time, so the skeleton warriors were going to be summoned at level 3. As a druid, I was the party's designated summoner, and the robe was given to me. Flash forward several real life months, and we're in a battle at level 16. I decide to finally summon those skeletons for the first time. GM, you still have that? Me, yeah. GM, why haven't you used it? Me, we were scared of the skeletons. GM, what? Why? Me, we weren't sure they'd immediately start attacking us. GM, well, they will fight on your side. But why are you using it now they're summoned at level 3? You're fighting level 16 enemies now. Me, because at level 16, I'm not scared of them hitting me. As the fight progresses, our GM is mostly ignoring Boney and Skells, because they can only deal about one stroke for the damage our party can. Skells gets killed in collateral splash damage, though, but Boney keeps hanging on. I'm rolling super luckily on his turn. He never misses an attack. He's only doing about 1/5 damage, but he just can't seem to miss. He ends up getting a kill, helps flank enemies for our melee fighters, and survives the whole battle. 13 levels past his prime. I had a recurring gnome character that sold several gag magic items intended to be used as pranks, including Ring of Invisibility. It's just invisible. It doesn't do anything when you put it on, and since it's invisible it doesn't even serve the purpose of being ornamental. Never-burning torch. A torch that absolutely, positively does not light. It's also too lightweight to use as a club. Amulet of spell turning. Literally all it does is spell the word turning out loud when activated. In common. In the voice of Gilbert Gottfried. Bag of molding. A bag that causes mold to grow on anything placed within it. Oil of slipperilessness. Oil that is no more slippery than water. Lying carpet. A carpet that always replies to your questions with lies. The drawback is that the carpet is sentient, so it's entirely capable of unintentionally telling the truth. Ring of infinite wishes. The only thing you can wish for is more wishes. Invisible hard objects are great though. You just drop them into a machine. Or in the case of a ring, work them around a cog tooth. And then laugh as people absolutely fail to understand why their crap doesn't work. They haven't figured out how to use it yet. But I gave my party a jar of kraken bait. Full of rancid fish magically enchanted to attract a giant octopus when thrown in the water. The only problem? The jar is also cursed. And whoever possesses the jar loses the ability to open any door or containers that require any sort of twisting motion. They can't open it. This is what you get for seriously considering buying the ring that turns you into a were-a-crocodile and giving the DM a how the frick do I balance this heart attack. And the best part? They never stopped to ask if the jar is even a twist top. It's not. They just assumed they couldn't open it. Not my story but my BF's. In a campaign they found a magical bag that contained infinite water. It was great until one of the characters accidentally spilled some soup in it and it became an infinite bag of soup, which was pretty funny. During one session, the DM noted that they didn't close the bag of infinite soup before heading out on a quest. So, when they got back, the bag had opened the infinite soup dimension and flooded the walled-in city where they left it. They had to swim through a sea of soup to find and close the bag, and then they managed to get a spell off to turn the city walls into bread. So they turned an entire city into a gigantic bread bowl of soup lumpheo. My group had a habit of giving items that sounded very useful but were the complete opposite. For example, our wizard was gifted a wand of fireball. As you'd expect, he was extremely disappointed when in the middle of combat he used the wand and fireball by Pitbull started playing mid-fight. One of my favorite gag items was a ring of teleportation. Every time you attempted to use it, the ring would teleport to the destination of your choosing, just not with you. Worst time to figure that out was when I, the rogue, was cornered and alone, fighting three wolves, which at level 2 was not fun. The first time it was used, it teleported to the inn we had been staying at, and when we got back apparently it had been taken. So we never got to use it as a weapon and teleport it into anyone's brains. One of my favorite gag items was a ring of teleportation. Every time you attempted to use it, the ring would teleport to the destination of your choosing, just not with you. That's funny as frick. I got the idea from the YouTuber Puffin Forest to give my players a broken sword of warning. Basically, every morning the sword would say something bad might happen today, and if something even slightly bad would happen, it would tell the party about how it warned them. Sometimes, it would blow their cover if they were sneaking around. The fighter ended up getting so annoyed with it that he spent money on opening a portal to Limbo. Then he tossed the sword into it. The campaign ended a while ago, but in a lot of my new campaigns, when the players visit Limbo, I will make a reference to the sword. English not my first language. In one of my campaigns there was a store dedicated only to selling useless magical items for insanely cheap prices. I had a table of at least 80 items. One of my favorites was the Rod of Immovability, which becomes completely impossible to move when activated. The catch is that it's immovable in relation to the center of the universe, so it just flies away due to the planet's movement. No one ever activated it for fear of piercing the planet's core. Bind the BBEG to it. Activate Rod. Either he gets shot into space, or plowed through the planet. Either way, that's a lot of dice to figure out the damage. A trinket that can excavate a 15ft x 15ft section of earth down to a depth of 5 feet. Turns out, I had also given them at some point prior a trinket that fills roughly the same volume with water. Also turns out that water can be frozen. Surprising how many problems can be solved with various permutations of the applications of those three. For starters, anything under 5 feet tall can be suffocated if the person with the ability to freeze declares their cast as a reaction to the water being created in the pit. Anything around about 6 feet tall just gets its head kicked in while it's frozen in place. Fire as a hazard? Forget it. Spike pits? Nor. Traps? Pressure plates? Combat on stairs? Nope. Anything that allows line of sight into an otherwise enclosed space? Yeah, everything inside is drowned now. Need an attack of opportunity? Make everything in front of you fall 5 feet into that hole you just materialized and cast a saving throw. Think before you give non-combat tools to players. They can and absolutely will use them to break everything around them. Give a child a hammer and all that. The DM giveth. But the DM must also remember to tacketh away. Got this idea from Reddit actually. Had a campaign where the heroes defeated a coven of hags at their lair. Afterwards, a floating stick would follow them around everywhere. The players were curious, so they threw the stick away. It came back every time. So they cast detect magic on the stick, but it wasn't magical in any way. The players were completely dumbfounded and determined to figure out what this stick's deal was. How could it float, return every time, and not be magical? Eventually they gave up trying to solve it and went on with the campaign, believing that I, the DM, had no resolution in mind and was just making stuff up. About 30 sessions later, the wizard died and entered the ethereal plane. There, he saw his comrades and the stick and a dog, the ghost of a dog, the hag's pet, who kept returning the stick, thinking the players were playing fetch every time. This broke the player's heart, and the wizard was determined to make the ghost dog his new familiar. So when I first started playing D&D about 8 years ago, I was extremely shy and nervous to RP. In the second session, as we were headed to a meeting with a representative of one of the more powerful churches in the R, we came across a guy selling potions of firewater, guaranteed to boost your confidence. The DM and the rest of the players had a chuckle at this, as he was obviously just selling booze. I, being a naive 14-year-old who knew nothing about names for booze, I assumed this was actually some sort of magical confidence boosting potion. Fast forward to the meeting. It's not going well. I'm really nervous for real, so decide to drink one of those potions mid-meeting. The DM tells me yay, I definitely feel more confident. After a few minutes he says, actually, could you use your words a bit more? So I did, playing along. After the meeting ended, he had me roll a constitution check, and when I failed he described how I was having a hard time walking straight, and my vision was getting funny, and it finally clicks. Hang on, am I just drunk? Cue the whole table bursting into laughter, not having realized I had no idea what firewater meant, and thinking I was just really into committing to this bit. Quite a fond memory of a very misinformative potions dealer. Quell's Feather Token, Tree. This item is a one-time use feather that turns into a tree when the command word is spoken. We all laughed about how useless it was and the rogue nonchalantly offered to hold onto it. Several sessions later everyone had forgotten about it. The rogue randomly brings up birds in conversation. After an abundance of avian allegories, all adventure abated. During the discussion, it was determined that the quill portion of the feather is indeed sharp. Several sessions after that, Quell's Feather Token Tree was a distant memory. We get to the boss fight and are getting our asses absolutely handed to us. Everyone had resigned themselves to the TPK that was about to happen. Everyone but the rogue who, nearly unconscious, says, okay guys, I got this. He tumbled next to the boss, pulled out the feather, stabbed him, said the command word and dove for cover. The feather, stuck in the boss chest, transforms into a lovely apple tree, basically obliterating the boss. The rogue picks an apple, takes a bite and calmly says, right, so, I'd like to search the room. Reminds me of the first episode of The Orville. Happy Arbor Day. Technically Pathfinder, but, we were playing a campaign where we were starting our own city and eventually country, as a troop of evil wizards. Early on, one of us got a robe of infinite twine, which lets you pull a loose thread on the robe which magically turns into rope. It is basically a magic item with infinite free rope. For the rest of the campaign, whenever our group would interrogate anyone, or really just come across anyone we didn't like, We would do so by force-feeding them rope from the rope to death. At one point in the campaign, one of our neighbor factions gifted us with a monument as a thanks for helping them in some war, and we were presented with a giant sculpture of our party force-feeding some poor bastard a bunch of rope. It became the centerpiece for our city and a warning to our citizens and enemies alike. So in D&D 5e, the bag of beans is a pretty useless item in most cases, with the effects ranging from pointless, to mildly beneficial, to harmful, to even more harmful, but with a shot at great loot. The way it works is you take a bean from the bag, plant it, and the DM rolls for a result. In the campaign I'm currently running and making posts about because it's awesome, the paladin tried to get church to donate funds for some relief efforts after a town had been suffering from demon invasions. Unfortunately, because of internal politics, he couldn't get the funding. One of the families who had lost their daughter were thankful to Paladin for turning back the demons, so they gave him a bag of beans. They said they got swindled from a blind merchant and had no use for them as they were too afraid to meddle in high arcane. The Paladin went ahead and planted one in the fields to see what would happen. From the spot of soft dirt, erupted a geyser that shot out crude oil. The Paladin whipped out his portable hole and filled it up with over 2,000 gallons of oil. He sold it all to the kingdom's military and made a killing. Now if a flask of oil is 1 silver coin, and a flask is about 1 cup, that means this guy sold over 3,000 gold pieces worth of oil. He took all of that gold and donated it to rebuild the town and compensate the families who had lost so much in the destruction of their homes. TLDR. The Paladin got a bag of beans, became an oil tycoon, and donated the profits to a charitable cause. It was about halfway into my campaign, I had a cool treasure waiting for them in this cave. Before they even knew what was inside the chest, they all shouted. I opened the chest and grabbed the treasure. This had been going on for a while, to the point where it actually created conflict between players. So I thought, okay, frick the thing that was supposed to be in the chest, I'm giving these greedy bastards the most useless thing I could think of. They opened up the chest and inside is a single wooden wand. One of the players shout, I use IT. I then describe how a huge burst of arcane energy shoots out and lands on the ground. Once the smoke and dust settles, what's left on the ground is a single wooden wand. I had given my players a creation that I had came up with on the fly, a wand with the ability to duplicate itself, the Wand of Wanding. TLDR. My players were getting annoying and greedy when it came to magic items, so I gave them the Wand of Wanding. This wasn't mine, but I once read about a DM that gave his players a ring that creates an area around it of anti-magic that's only small, so that you could easily pick magic locks, etc. One of the players was a gunslinger and got the wizard in the team to shrink cannonballs to fit in his gun. Then they placed the ring on the end of the barrel, so as he shot them they got bigger, essentially making an actual hand cannon. Thought that was a pretty smart use of the item. I read this somewhere, I didn't do it, but I think depending on how you DM it either works or it doesn't. If you're a stickler for the rules, which is fine, that fair. If you bend the rules to have a bit more of a relaxed game, that's fine as well. We were in the lair of something underground and they found a chest, and there was a nice red pair of leather boots. That's what the adventure said. It didn't mean nothing. They were just red because the adventure said so. Players got hung up on it and in the end joked about how these must be magic boots, and in the end our elf put them on and clacked his heels together. I decided, oh come on, and made them draw a bright yellow path wherever he went, until he again clacked his heels. Like the yellow road in Wizard of Oz, they never used them, because, apart from convulsed dungeons we never played in, they are not useful, unless you want to be tracked. Additionally, it was not D&D and magic items are 8 and super expensive. But no one wanted a pair of boots that colors the ground yellow. Oh man, I love making dumb little trinkets and bits. But this one thing I made was stashed away in the bank vault of a western style town, where the only resident is a construct dressed like a sheriff, and all the townsfolk are missing. They figured out the mystery of the town. Construct killed them all and went crazy using their bodies as dolls. They fought giant dune worms. They were stalked for 2 days by this sheriff robot, tried killing him and couldn't. Somehow managed to collapse a town on him. They grabbed this little treasure box and ran out of the town. Well, inside was a little jewelry box. Inside was a marble. So basically tiny white polished stone sphere. What could it be? They risked their lives on this side quest to get it. It was kept in a vault and everything. They held it up, and once it was under open sky, it zipped out the player's hand and rolled like 60 miles per hour off randomly into the desert, leaving a cartoonist dust trail. It was the Marble of Whitewall, homebrew name for a city I placed in my world's canon, North Pole Arctic themed cliff city. The marble fricked off north and it'll only stop once it reaches the true North Pole. The wrong direction of where they're going, and also totally useless. If they'd bothered to search the vault instead of booking it with the first thing they found, they'd have realized this construct hoards tiny magical trinkets like Wall-E. I wasn't the DM of this campaign, but I was the party member who received the item. It was the Horn of Valhalla, which, if you don't know, it's able to summon a hero to fight by your side for an hour, I think. The DM added his own flavor and said the horn could only summon a hero for our realm. Being new adventurers at the time, we knew nothing about the lore of the land and the great heroes before us. So this is where it gets useless and to the party funny. We had a bard with us at one point until he died to a green dragon. Leading up to the event of his death, he rolled natural 20s of what we say was the greatest performance on the planet to serenade the beholder. The beholder, impressed and confused, lets us basically go. Fast forward to after his death. The world now knows of his magnificent song to the beholder, and no bard can match the performance, only tribute to the greatest song of the world. Fast forward again, we end up getting the horn and I use it to summon our bard back, but instead of fighting by our side, he sings songs and inspires us. Then disappears again for a month until the item can be used for the same purpose. There were time where I got drunk in character and blew the horn just to talk to my old companion. Sorry if it's not that funny, being there made it funnier to me. Boots of air walking. Basically, they were boots that could not move closer to the ground. So they let you walk on air like you would up a staircase, but then you don't have a way down. Also, you could lose your balance, fall over, and hang upside down from the boots. The ranger was dragged along like a kite for half of the day, and spent the night about 60 feet up while the druid prepared a spell to remove the curse that meant he couldn't take them off. They are now trying to pawn it off to some unsuspecting shopkeeper. I think the moral of that story is that you shouldn't trust a pair of boots on a pedestal in the middle of a grain field with a beam of light descending down from the heavens upon it. One of my players is a cleric of dreams, and I gave her a magical sleeping mask that, if put on a sleeping person, will indefinitely sustain their sleep with incredibly vivid nightmares of their future death. Another one of my players is an Asama who has prophetic dreams. When my players were traveling between two cities, they encountered a man who claimed to be a guide. He said he knew the secrets to safe travels, and he played a magic banjo. My players were immediately suspicious of him, but they decided to go along with him. Over the next few days of travel, the elf ranger caught him doing several strange things in the middle of the night, poking around their belongings. But each time he had some excuse to save his hide. Until, a night before they arrived at their destination, he went poking around the dream cleric's backpack and pulled out the mask. She woke up, looked him in the eyes, and then nodded and pretended to go back to sleep. As he crept up to the sleeping Asima, the elf came out of her trance and stopped him from putting the mask on the prophet. They fought and killed him, of course. But they didn't fully trust the dream cleric after that. I've yet to give them any magical items, as we are only 2 sessions in, but I plan on giving one person in the party a magical potato that never decays or rots. Its sole magical effect is that, once per hour, the potato is magically transported into the inventory of another ally with infinite range. The potato can also be written on with ink, which is what I hope my players figure out. I hope they use it in case the party decide to split up and they need some way of finding each other by teleporting the potato to each other with information written on the potato. I haven't decided on the name yet, but I'm thinking hot potato or something along those lines. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.